R to R. Or both functions, G maps R to R. F maps R to R, G maps R to R are defined by f of x is equal to zero if x belongs to Q, one if x is not a rational number, and g of x defined minus 1 if x belongs to Q, 0 if x does not belongs to Q, that means x is not irrational. Then find f circle g of pi plus g circle f of e. This value we have to find out. Okay, now f circle g of pi, let us find out first this value. So, now f of g of pi, pi is not a rational number, pi is a transcendental number. So, that means irrational number only it comes under. So, now g of x function, when x is not rational, that takes value 0. So, that means now in this case g of x is equal to 0, that means g of pi is equal to 0, f of 0. But whereas 0 is a rational number, so 0 is a rational number means f of x is 0. So, that means this value is 0. Now, let us find out g circle f of e. This we can write g of f of e. E is also a transcendental number, e is not a rational number. When x is not rational number, f of x takes 1. So, that means f of e is equal to 1, g of 1. So, that means here f of x is equal to 1. Now, 1 is a rational number. Since 1 is a rational number, so in this definition g of x takes minus 1. So, now minus 1. So, now we have to find out f circle g of pi plus g circle f of e. So, this value is 0 plus of minus 1. 0 minus 1 equals to minus 1. Fourth problem. Let A is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3. B is equal to A comma B comma C. C is equal to P comma Q comma R. If F maps A to B, G maps B to C, are defined by f is equal to 1 comma a, 2 comma c, 3 comma b. G is equal to a comma q, b comma r, c comma p. Then show that F inverse circle G inverse is equal to G circle F whole inverse. This we have to prove. So first let us find out, given F is equal to 1A 2C 3B, G is equal to AQ BR CP. Now therefore let us find out G circle F. G circle F has the same domain of F only, that means 1 2 3. Here 1 maps to A maps to Q, that means 1 comma Q. 2 maps to C maps to P, so 2 to P. Next 3 maps B maps to R, 3 to R. This is G circle F. Now G circle F inverse. G circle F inverse is equal to, this is Q comma 1, P comma 2, 3 comma R. This is R comma 3. So equation 1. Now let us find out G inverse. G inverse is equal to Q comma A, R comma B, P comma C. Let us find out F inverse, inverse of F function. A comma 1, C comma 2, B comma 3. Let us find out F inverse circle G inverse. That means F inverse circle G inverse and G inverse have the same domain, that is P, Q, R itself only. P maps to C maps to 2, that is P comma 2. Now Q maps to A maps to 1, Q comma 1. R maps to B maps to C, R to 3. This is 2. Let us observe equation 1 and equation 2. P comma 2, P comma 2, Q comma 1, Q comma 1, R comma 3, R comma 3. These two sets have the same elements. That's why these two are equal. So hence, from 1 and 2, G circle F whole inverse equals to F inverse circle G inverse. It is proved. It is proved.